Our starting point in this course is the mathematical idea of a function. In this lecture, I'll talk about what functions are and how to think about them, how to use functional notation, and how to interpret functions as graphs. Let's get started. In this course, I think the best way to think about functions are as an action, which I've illustrated here. So a function is an action. It takes an input, some number x as an input, f, that's the name of the function, it does something to x, and then it outputs a new value, which we call f of x. So to specify a function, we have to specify what this action is, what the action does. So as a concrete example, let's say f is a function that triples its input. So we could write an equation for that. We could say f of x equals 3x. So f triples the input. So suppose that our input was 2. Then it would output 6, because 2 times 3 is 6. Using this notation, let's say f of 2, we replace x with 2, be 3 times 2 is 6. So we'll say f of 2, f acting on the number 2, gives the output 6. Let's try another input. Here's our function called f. Let's say the input now is 5. The output would be 15, 5 times 3. F of 5. We take 5 as an input, and then this tells us to do f to it. In this case, that means multiply by 3. 3 times 5 equals 15. Let's do one more quick example. Same function f. Suppose the input now is 0. That's nothing. 0 times 3 is still 0. So in this case, it outputs the same number that it inputs. If you have nothing and you triple it, you still have nothing. Using this notation, f of 0 is 3 times 0. 3 times 0 is 0. So the rule is x is the input, and then you evaluate the output on the right-hand side here by replacing whatever the input number is on the right. So here we have a 2, we replaced x with 2. Here we have a 5, we replace x with 5. If, for example, we had f acting on some other variable, the letter z, that would be just 3 times z. The actual value would depend on z. If we had something like f acting on a heart, who knows what that would mean? You have a heart, then you triple the heart, you have 3 hearts. Let's do another example. This time the function, I'll call it g, will be x squared plus 1. So remember, a function is an action. It takes a number as input, it does something to it, and it gives an output. We specify the function by saying what that action is. What rule does it follow to go from the input to the output? In this case, the rule is take the input number, square it, and add 1. So let's evaluate this function for a few different values. So let's say our input is 3. So that would mean g of 3. So what do? I take 3 and I square it. That's the rule. 3 squared plus 1. Well, 3 squared, that's 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. So we would say that g of 3 is 10. We start with 3, g acts on it, we get 10. Using this notation, here's g. 3 comes inside this box. 3 gets squared and then gets 1 added to it. So 10 comes out. All right, let's do another example. Suppose our input is 0. So we start with 0, and then we do what the function tells us to do to evaluate it. The function says square it and add 1. So we've got 0 squared, and I add 1. And 0 squared, that's 0 times 0. 0 times 0, well, that's still 0. So g of 0 is 1. We would have 1 coming in the box, and we would have 0 coming in the box and 1 coming out the box. Let's do one more. Let's try a negative number now. So our input is negative 2. That means we would take negative 2, square it, and add 1. Negative 2 squared, well, that's negative 2 times negative 2. Negative 2 times negative 2, the negatives cancel. That would be plus 4 plus 1. So that would be 5. One last thing I want to mention, just a note about notation. So notice I'm using parentheses, say here and here, but these parentheses mean different things. Here, this means multiply. Take negative 2, multiply it by negative 2. Here, this doesn't mean take negative 2 and multiply it by g. This means take the number negative 2, view it as input to the function or the action g, and let g act on it. So the notation can be a little bit confusing at first, particularly if you haven't seen this before. But it's important to remember that a function is an action, and this type of notation, functional notation, the parentheses is interpreted as the input value. It doesn't mean multiply. I'll have more to say about functions in the next video. But before you watch that video, I suggest that you try out the quiz that immediately follows this video in the navigation bar. A reminder that the quizzes are not part of your evaluation for this course. In fact, the scores aren't even recorded at all. They're just a chance for you to practice some of the ideas you're learning and to take a break from listening to me talk. So, give it a try.